In these streets, I'm walking on air. In these streets, I don't have a care.
Hey, girls, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna. And it's your first time stopping by. Hello. 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 Hello, boo. So today's video, I'm going to take you all through this hairstyle that's giving natural, it's giving Afrocentric, it's giving everything right now for holidays, for Christmas. In fact, for every condiment you can think of, this is the hairstyle for you. And let me just add some extra spice right there for you, y'all. This hairstyle, there is no wig, there is no crochet, but it's giving extra natural. Alright, so the first thing I have to do right now is to spritz my natural hair with some water just to soften it a bit. My natural is already quite stretched out because I had it in some form of, I think it was in some form of cornrows or twists, like about a week before this hairstyle. But the first thing I'm going to go ahead to do right now, we parted out the side. And this side of our natural that we parted out, don't worry about it, just put that away. We're going to use it for a special type of condiment. And for the rest of our natural hair right here, this fro on this other side, we're going to put this all the way into flat twists. You could do cornrows, you could do single braids, depending on whichever works for you, but you just want this area to be flat. It doesn't have to be so flat because you're going to be wearing like curly hair extension. So you know curly hair and yeah, it's already poofy, so it doesn't have to be so flat, but just try to lay your natural hair as flat as you can. Flat twist, single braid, single twist, cornrows would work perfecto for you. And I just wanted to point this out, y'all. I think I forgot while I was doing my entire flat twist, I got caught up. The very first flat twist that we did in front, you do not have to do that one. In fact, you don't even need it. We're not supposed to do it, so you can, you know, that very first one right there that I just grabbed, you can leave that out because we needed that leave out for the rest of our clippings. Y'all don't see what I mean. I ended up taking that one out. But right now, I'm just going to go ahead to add and join all of these flat twists together. And I use my crochet needle to tuck this into my natural hair just so everything is laid flat and flatulicious. And I'm going to go right now to use this hair oil. I just use this oil in my scalp because I realized my scalp is getting dry. This winter, it's not playing with anybody solo. It's not playing with anybody at all. And then the hair extension I'm using is from Betterlength. This is the 4B to 4C Afro Kinky Coily Clippings in natural color, and it's also in 14 inches. The first thing we're going to go right now to make this hair extension to be extra, you know, we're going to go ahead to wash this, co-wash this with some conditioner. And the conditioner I'm using is the Curly Hair Mask from the Curls Popping Pineapple Collection. As you can see, it already has this hair popping. Can't you see how it's popping? And I allowed that to sit for about 30 minutes to 1 hour while I did my thing, and then I came back and rinsed off this conditioner. This made the hair feel extra soft. It defined the curls and just made it to be, you know, like extra luscious. It was giving juiciness, it was just giving tantalizing. And then moving on to the installation part of these clippings, we're going to go right now to start opening these clippings. Pium 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 right there, and I start clipping it. Bah, bah, bah. Open. Make sure you open your clippings before you install it. I did used to do that before when I started wearing clippings initially, and I realized that I don't know what I was doing. So just make sure that you're opening each clipping, like open it and then clip this onto your natural hair. We're clipping this towards like as if you're doing a parting, like a side parting, so everything is going towards the side just so it's fluffy at this side. That's basically the style we're going for. And then I just clip this all around and make sure that I fill in every part of my head. For this entire head of hair, the entire bundle of hair extension, just one pack would be enough for you, because I even had like two remaining, as y'all can see, those two left. And yeah, that was it for this entire part. As y'all can see, we also left out that front first line of flat twists I told you all about, so with importance, we're going to need that for leave out. For the rest of this hair extension right now, we're going to go ahead to start doing twist, because I was doing a twist out to define the curls, and just y'all will see what we are going for. Y'all will see. Okay, for this entire twist, I spritzed some water onto this hair extension because it had dried a little bit, and then I used my Curls Blueberry Leave-In Conditioner, and then to seal all of that moisture, I used my shea butter. This has chebe powder in it. Honestly, the content of this shea butter doesn't really matter. Just get a good moisturizer that you can use to seal in your leave-in conditioner. I put this hair into twist. It's on the hair extension, right? So the ingredient is not, it's not, you know, it's not as compulsory if it was on your natural hair. You just need something that will soften and define your curls.
So running through this entire process again, we use water to spritz on our natural hair, on our clippings, and then I use the Curls Blueberry Bliss Leave-In Conditioner and seal all of that moisture using shea butter. I put this into single stranded twists. Did this for my entire head of Afro clippings right there. And once we got to the front, this is the leave out section. I'm just going to go ahead right now to unravel this flat twist. So grabbing my hair strand, my natural hair in front, we're going to marinate and merge this into this clippings right there. Just like so. Grab that. There you go. And repeat the entire process of twisting. We're going to make sure that we're grabbing our natural hair alongside. Spritz of water right there. This is going to add and just make everything soft, and then go ahead and apply your leave-in conditioner to both your natural hair and the hair extension, and then seal with your shea butter. Brush through just to make sure it's detangled, everything is separated, it's giving, it's just serving what it needs to serve, and merge both your natural hair into this hair extension, and then twist it all the way to the very end. Okay, so this was how I ended up merging and blending our natural hair onto these clippings right here in front. I'm gonna bake them a pie and sit on the porch till it's night. Nothing can make me feel down, down, down. Not every day is like this, so I'ma soak up what I got. While it is the newspaper, I'll read later. Right now I'm feeling so good. Yo, so that was basically it for the entire blending right there. And once we got to this other side, we just went ahead to grab some of our natural hair from this portion of hair that we have here. Just get some of your natural hair, just a little bit, don't need too much, just slightly right there, and you're good to go. Get some right there at the back as well to conceal the clippings right there at the back, and then repeat the entire twisting process while marinating both your natural hair and the clippings together right here on the sides. Good place, and nothing can make me feel down, down, down. Jump back if you're trying to come sideways. I don't need your bad vibes today. But if you want to change your tone, you can play. But nothing can make me feel down, down, down. And voila! This is basically all I did for this entire twisting section. This is it for our twist right now. Y'all, I literally went to bed. I went to bed, allowed this to dry, take its time and do its thing. But I was already feeling the, you know, the prospects of this hairstyle. I was already seeing the vision at this point. So I just tied my head down. Y'all, normally it's advisable for you not to sleep with clippings. So if you can do this hairstyle in the morning, so by the time you're about to, you're ready to go out, or maybe in the evening, it's all dried down. If you have to sleep with your clippings, please try not to sleep on the side that has this clipping. So I tried to make sure I was sleeping on my other side. That's this side of my head that I parted, just so there's no pressure on my scalp, if that makes sense. And then moving on to this side of our natural hair right now, we're going to do kind of like a triangle parting, okay? And we only need three parting for this entire hair style. Yo, please ignore the noise in the background. There's a construction going on right behind my house. So yeah, just ignore that, please. Thank you. And then for the hair extension, we're using for this corner of our hair, I'm using a kinky hair extension. This is just a leftover hair extension that I had sitting around. I just felt this was going to blend perfectly well with our natural hair. I believe this hair extension I'm using here is the Outre Twisted Up Springy Afro Twist. You could also use Expression. I think Expression has, they have a really nice kinky hair extension as well. Just find any kinky hair extension that matches with our type 4 natural hair. It will blend perfectly well with this entire segment. Okay, on the other hand though, if you also want like a perfect blend, you could actually cut your clippings to use as an extension for this entire twisted bantu knot segment that we're going to be doing right now. But yo, I feel like these clippings, it's natural, right? It's human hair. I beg, it's too expensive. I was like, I don't want to destroy my clippings. So I just picked up like a random kinky hair extension that I had in my wardrobe, okay? So for this segment, I started off with the regular three-stranded braid, and I'm going to twist to the very end. Depending on what you're comfortable with, if you're not really comfortable with gripping the roots of your natural hair, you could actually use the rubber band method. I'll put that video down below, where you could actually, you know, use crochet, pass the extension through your natural hair, and then start twisting. that could also work for you, either or. But we just needed to do like a twisted bantu knot right here, okay? So to make sure that everyone is following and we're all doing the Lord's work over here, we're going to repeat this entire process again, okay? So parting our natural hair right there, like I said, I was doing like a triangle parting. That was the vibe I was going for this side of our natural hair. So grab that, comb through, and then grab your hair extension, crisscrosses over each other. That is if you're going to be starting off with three stranded braids. Crosses over each other right there, as you can see. Grab a little bit, just a tiny bit though, tiny bit of your shine and jam gel, just smoothing your natural hair right there. Slick it together and then grab your edge brush to brush through slowly. So once that's all marinated and all our natural hair strands, they're marrying each other, okay, we're going to go right now to split our natural into three segments, which we're going to place this hair extension onto, and then you just go ahead to start in your regular three stranded braid. Cross it right there. Do about 2 to 3 steps. Just make sure that the root of your hair is properly secure. Once you get to about 2 to 3 steps, split your hair extension into 2 sides on each side of this hair extension. So just split everything to equal sides, okay? And then start twisting all the way to the very end. Once you get to the very end, that is it. You just go ahead, grab this hair extension, swirl it all around. It's a very nice, juicy, and luscious bantu knot right there. And look at how natural that looks. It looks flawless, doesn't it? One quick thing I feel like I wish I had done was to make my extension smaller, just my bantu knot a lot smaller, but it's still came out looking pretty good. But if you're doing yours, try to like measure or try to see the thickness of your bantu knot prior to, I don't know how to explain what I'm saying, but so for the rest of my hair right now, I'm going to go ahead and start taking down this twist. I left this twist overnight and I just applied some oil on my palms. This is a jojoba oil. This is just going to like grease my hands just so I could also reduce the potential of frizz while taking this twist down. And after taking it down, I realized I wanted it to be a little bit fuller and more fluffed out, so I just went ahead to start separating this twist to give it more of an afro, you know, afro flawless twist out look with a little bit of frizz, I don't know, like just a little bit of condiments. And then I went ahead to use my afro pick comb right there to pick this just to give it a little bit more density like I previously mentioned, and cut out all of the excess ends, any ends that were looking a little bit strandy, funny. And that was it for this hairstyle, y'all. And of course, hey, it's been a while, we had to do what? Accessorize our hair. Nah, eh. I just added that extra glitter right there on the bantu knot. Pium, 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 pium. That took the hairstyle to the next level. No, but seriously though. Are you seeing this hairstyle? When you step out with this kind of hairstyle, people be asking you, what is your name again? Yo, well, that's it for this video, y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed it and happy holidays. Let me know down below in the comment section if you're going to rock this hairstyle and where you're going to rock this hairstyle to, because guess what? It's giving holiday, giving Bejoku vibes, it's giving hot chocolate cake. Thumbs up if you enjoyed it, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you all in my next one. I love you all so very much. Have a lovely rest of your weekend. Bye.